Thomas Edison is the most patented American in history, with 1,093 patents to his name in the US, and 1,239 more internationally. You're probably familiar with some of Edison's more well-known inventions, like the light bulb, or the phonograph, or the motion picture camera. But what about some of his lesser-known inventions? When he was just 22, Edison was issued his first patent, the electrographic vote recorder. Legislators could choose yes or no on a ballot, and an electric current would pass through the device. Later, chemicals would dissolve the side that the legislator voted for. Congress was not impressed. More impressive were Edison's batteries, which were among his most profitable inventions. By the late 1880s, he had developed the primary battery, which became an industry standard. Edison believed the world needed electric cars, which needed lighter batteries than the prevailing lead-acid ones. It took him nearly 10 years and 147 related patents before finishing his alkaline storage battery. Though gas-powered cars were already dominating the market by then, Edison's storage batteries were a commercial success, manufactured in New Jersey until the mid-1970s. In 1876, Edison patented the electric stencil pen. A small electric motor powered a steel needle to perforate paper. It was the first widely used copying technology. And later, the electric pen would be modified into the first electric tattoo needle. We've already mentioned how the phonograph is one of Edison's most famous patents, recorded sound. But did you also know that in 1890, he patented the first talking doll? The miniature phonograph placed inside a doll held a 6-second recording of songs and nursery rhymes. Unfortunately, the mini phonograph was a bit too delicate for playful little girls, and the sounds mostly came out as hissing or crackling noises, horrifying wealthy children across the country. Edison also had a patent for a concrete house, which he argued could be made for the third of the price of a typical house, if made from a concrete mold. He even proposed making the furnishings from concrete, from pipes, to tables and chairs, to pianos and record players, and even bathtubs. In his busiest year, Thomas Edison applied for 106 patents. That averages out to about 2 each week. He's one of America's most prolific inventors, but he certainly didn't work alone. Find out more from Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, and pbs.org/American Experience.